So Taylor Swift was basically my gateway drug into country music. When I was in my teenage years, I had not yet discovered country music, but I had discovered Taylor Swift. And I remember listening to Love Story and dreaming of one day having my own love story. I remember listening to 15 and being 15 and just relating to literally everything. I remember wanting to go back to December and to see sparks fly and to be enchanted. But alas, times change, children grow up, friends move away, and Taylor Swift moves on from country to pop. But what I can say is that she gave me my first taste of country, and when I tasted country, there was no going back. Anyways, Taylor Swift just released a new album called Lover. And no, I'm not here today to review that album because, fortunately or unfortunately, this is a country music channel and we don't talk about pop here. So instead, I'd like to explore the question, how country is Taylor Swift's new Lover album? So this begs the question, what makes something country? Does it have to be about trucks and beer and small towns? Does it have to come from the American South? Do they have to sing with a southern accent? Is there fiddle or banjo or steel guitar? Or can it sound completely like pop but still be country if it's produced in Nashville by an artist signed to a country record label and it is played on country radio? My ultimate philosophical answer is, if you think it's country, then it is country. And if a group of people thinks that it is country, then it is country. The definitions of words are a very subjective experience that is constantly evolving. The genres are constantly changing as well, so it's really impossible to define. Of course, though, there are certain correlations between what society considers country right now and the elements of those songs. For the purpose of this video, I decided to be a total nerd and create this beautiful spreadsheet with all 18 songs in the new album where I rated each of them on three different categories. Please hit the like button if you are also a total nerd who likes to make spreadsheets in your free time. Oh, wait, nobody? I rated each song on its country-ness on three criteria. Instrumentation, melody, and lyrics. Basically, 0 means not country at all, 1 means somewhat country-ish, and 2 means super country. In terms of instrumentation, for 2, I'm looking for acoustic sounds and stringed instruments, extra points if there's a banjo in there. For melody, I'm looking for simple chords. I've noticed a lot of songs where the instrumentation wasn't country, but the melody I could see being a country song. Lyrics and themes, which happens to be my favorite category, is basically I'm looking for storytelling and specific details and imagery. That's what country music is all about. Maybe it creates an emotion or a sense of place. It has to feel authentic. So after rating all of these songs, I calculated the grand total for each song. So each song came out to an overall country-ness score of 0 to 6. And then I analyzed all the results, and like a true scientific researcher, I shall now present my findings. So I had an initial hypothesis that the countrier the song, the more I would like it, and it turns out that this hypothesis was correct. In other words, my favorite songs, based on my raw, subjective, qualitative experience, had a positive correlation with the quantitative country-ness score that I computed using this method. So I've created this like timeline spectrum thingy, 'cause why not? And basically identified 5 categories of songs based on their final scores. So we have 5 songs that are definitely not country, 6 songs that are probably not country, 5 songs that are somewhat country, 1 song that is pretty country, and 1 song that is super country. So let's just work our way from left to right. So let's start with the songs that are definitely not country with a score of 0. Basically, there was absolutely nothing country about them at all. If you are someone who hates country music, you will probably love these songs. These songs are basically my personal least favorite. Okay, I gotta admit that I Forgot You Existed is actually like a pretty catchy song to me. But a lot of these songs in this category are really percussion or rhythm driven rather than lyrics. I honestly don't really like any of these songs, so let's just move right along. So now we have songs that are probably not country, so I gave them an overall score of 1. So this means that one aspect was maybe a little bit country. So there's 3 songs where I thought the melody was somewhat country-ish. The chorus of Cruel Summer has a really nice melody to me, and this song along with Archer and Me, I could actually see being like a pop country song if you changed up the instrumentation. And then there's 3 songs where I thought the lyrics were country-ish. So Death by a Thousand Cuts has some really nice descriptive imagery in there. I like the line, "I see you everywhere, the only thing we share is this small town." Like, if you mention small towns, you get some country points. False God also has a hint of story, and it also has a lot of religious imagery, which I find pretty country. It's Nice to Have a Friend also has some really nice imagery. You have the school bells ringing, the sidewalk chalk covered in snow, and the light pink sky. So now we have 5 songs that are somewhat country with a score of 2 to 3. So I'm starting to like these songs a little bit more than the previous ones. I think that these songs could be made country with some tweaks to the instrumentation, though I'm not saying you necessarily should do that here. So Daylight has a country-ish melody and lyrics. Paper Rings sounds a lot like Blink-182 to me, but it's super fun and catchy and has great descriptions. I like the line, "The wine is cold like the shoulder I gave you in the street." Miss Americana and the Heartbreak Prince also has really beautiful lyrics and tells a story. Then we have London Boy, which is super catchy and descriptive, and it's about her lover, so that you got that raw, authentic, personal storytelling element. I like the line, "You know I love Springsteen, faded blue jeans, Tennessee whiskey." Just like that line makes this song more country. And finally we have Cornelia Street, which is yet another beautiful emotional story song. So now we have a song that is our number 2 most country song on the album, and surprise, it's the title track, Lover. I love the waltz time, of course. I talk about that all the time. I love how it's like pretty acoustic in terms of instrumentation, and I just want to grab someone and slow dance to the song. It feels super personal and authentic and kind of reminds me of Enchanted. So finally, we have the number 1 most country song on this album, and you guessed it, it's Soon You'll Get Better. Right away, this is definitely, obviously, my most favorite song on this album because my personal definition of heaven is slow, sad country music. That's like my jam, and there's also a banjo on here, yay! A fiddle, and it features the Dixie Chicks. So how much more country can it get? If you share my music taste in any way, this will probably be your favorite song as well. It cuts straight to the core of her emotions, and you can tell it's this intensely personal song for Taylor Swift. Like, she can't even talk about it in interviews without wanting to cry. It's just the most beautiful, raw, authentic song on this album, and that, my friends, is what country music is all about and why I love it. It's all about authenticity and stories of real life. What else can you ask for from a song? So I hope this was fun in some way, and I hope you guys have a really wonderful day/week/month/year/life.